Back on the bench, I know a lot of you have been waiting for me to dive into this one ever since I did the 95 Supra. It's AMT's 125th scale 2006 Nissan 350Z. These are awesome rear drive sports cars. I love seeing them. Even today, we've got a nice set of glass in the box. Clear parts for the headlights, tinted for the taillights, and those are some complicated shapes, so I'm glad we don't have to try to work with those too hard. We've got four literal rubber band low profile tires. There is no room for sponsor or maker emblems on the side of that. These are literally rubber bands, excellent tread pattern in them, and they will stretch over the low pros, which are coming on screen right now. We've got some awesome interior details. Check out those subwoofers. Amp package or dress package for the back of the car. Small chrome details, even the front suspension is chromed. Headlight backers, engine cover, intake in chrome, exhaust in chrome, so you can decide what you want to leave that way, what you want to paint over. Those speakers, of course, are hollow on this side because they aim down in the back of the car, but that is some nice detail. We'll have to get some black wash and see how those come out. The enormous hoopty wheels, you could leave chrome. You could gel coat them to look like aluminum. Excuse me. You could repaint them into any color you'd like. They're beautifully molded all the way open. Nut detail on the inside. We've got our chrome exhaust system on here. So that's a nice looking tire package and wheel package in the car. It's got an all new decal set in this edition. We got some VeilSide, some NOS, NOS, nitrous oxide, road hugger. We got five license plates on there. Z emblems for the wheels and the side of the car. We got hood emblems. We got, no, six license plates, my mistake. We've got all kinds of gauges, NOS bottle decals, faded. This looks like very 90s, mid-2000 type logos. Awesome looking. We got some fake carbon fiber. That's a pretty nice decal sheet on there. Let me switch to the other side of the desk, start taking a look at the styrene. As you will see, it is molded in a really awesome deep blue metallic. Real sharp looking, I like that. We got a left side drive, full gauge package, all the nice instrumentation inside there, really sharp looking. We've got our nose piece. We've got our door panels. That blue plastic also makes details real nice to stand out. We've got our rear body piece. We're gonna see how these attach and what kind of fit we get out of them. We got the hood on this one. Unlike the Supra, you only get a choice of one set of seats. We can see two center consoles, which would mean obviously we're gonna find another dashboard in here pretty soon. Nice detail on both of them. Panel line wash after painting will sink right into those details. Let's get out the other two trees that are in the kit. And there we have it. The right side drive. So decide how you want to build it up. We've got our spoiler and body parts in the back there. We've got a beautiful steering wheel. We've got a smaller gauge package. Nice steering column. Fan, belt and pulley system. Exhaust manifolds, transmission, block halves, radiator, and intercooler, it looks like. We got our mirrors on the side there. So that is all nice looking on that tree. And the final tree, it's got a set of gorgeous disc brakes we can paint up in detail. Molded in slotted rotors. We've got, looks like a NOS delivery system or fuel injection on there. We've got three wipers, transaxle, skid plate, front suspension. Got all kinds of stuff. Actually, we've got all the wiper blades to do either drive system. So it is pretty authentic there. It's nice looking. We got our little shifter. We got our e-brake on there. All kinds of cool stuff in these. It's really cool. We've got three larger slugs of styrene. Here's our underbody. All the detail involved in that. We've got our interior bucket. You can see where those speakers are going to go. Two-seater, like a Nissan 350. Doesn't have any back seats or anything. small cargo area. And the body. Body kit built into this one. You can't build it stock, but I wouldn't want to on this one anyways. Beautiful blue molded plastic on there. That metallic sheen is really nice. I may end up doing this one finally. I haven't done one in a while where I don't paint the body and I just clear coat it and see what kind of results. Usually comes out very nice, but you can see nice molding on there. A lot of cool extra parts in there for building different versions. I'm going to start working on my version. We'll be right back. So far, so good on the build. Only about an hour, 15 minutes on assembly. And that's because a lot of the parts are going to be painted separately. I want to do them a little separately. We got our door panels all set up. They really don't need anything. They have holes here because they will get a switch panel and all that installed from the chrome tree later. So those are ready to be painted and detailed. Got the adorable little steering column glued together. And I'll be clamping that and painting it my interior color. We've got some chrome parts here that I don't want to stay completely chrome. I'm going to be hitting those with a matte clear and then detail painting and black washing and various things like the air cleaner and whatnot to get that to look cool. These are the exterior door handles. I want to do those in a contrasting color to the body. I don't want to have them in chrome or metallic look at all. We've got the dashboard here. I glued the gauge cluster in. Now we'll get this all painted up. Obviously, I'm building the right-hand drive version because that's the version that I want to see. We got the wiper blades and the rear wiper blades all cut apart. Just decide how you want to snap apart those trees so we can get those all painted and then attached to the body. I cut the mirrors free because I also don't want those body color. These have beautiful pins to locate them on the body. So you won't have any problem attaching them later. There won't be any stress or anything. And I want to paint them a different color. The same color I'm going to do the door handles, actually. Same as the spoiler. I want to do the spoiler in a contrasting color from the body. Just because that's what I see with a lot of these style cars. And if I built one, I would want it that way. So we're going to be doing that separately. We got our belt pulley system and fan all glued together. That'll be attached to the engine during final assemblies. I did the right-hand drive console. With the e-brake and the shifter, we'll be painting that up and then adding that to the body or to the interior as we go. I want to do the exhaust manifolds, and they have large locating pins for the side of the engine, so I don't need to glue those on for stability at all. They'll hold on very tight on their own. And the radiator and intercooler assembly, I want to paint up as a metallic color. So I've got them on their little tree, cut everything off, and I can get that painted. The seats glue together very nicely. They're supposed to have seams back there to begin with, so we'll be able to paint those, and they're going to look lovely inside the car. Our V6 is all set to go. You can see those huge locating marks for the exhaust manifolds or headers. I couldn't remember that word for a second there. So that's all set to go. We'll get that painted all up as one unit and get that in the car. Now, this is a custom car for me, not a stock representation of an engine. So you can paint the engine any color you desire. So make sure you have fun with that. We've got our cooler and coolant lines right here. Those will get painted up with the front end of the car. The underneath of the suspension is a large separate piece that we can attach. It's got large locating pins for the suspension and to go onto the car, so we can paint those separate. Same as those beautiful brakes. We can get those painted separately, get the calipers painted and detailed, and then attach that to the car. The interior tub, there was only one part they asked you to attach to the interior and paint an interior color. I don't know what those are, but they're attached on there. They'll get painted up as the same color as the carpet inside. The wheels I cut free. I do not want chrome wheels. I want to paint them a completely different color, so I'm going to be priming the wheels and then over covering them with a color coat. All of this here, I didn't want chrome or anything separate. I just wanted it to look like a plain basic underbody. So I've got that all glued together. You can see the nubs for the wheels. The large nubs on there, the suspension, this will all get painted one color, top and bottom, and then detailed by hand later. And that beautiful customized 350Z body. I've got the hood cut free. I'm not going to be painting the hood body color. I want that separate as a contrast. You can see how nice that fits with that front clip on there. We got the rear bumper on. Check out that seam line. There's your seam line, and there would be one on there in a real car. and on the front, just the fenders, that I'm going to try to just coat with a couple coats of Future when we're done and give it a gloss. I love that deep metallic blue. I probably would have sprayed it that color anyways. So we're all set right there. I'm going to get all this stuff over to paint. We'll be back in a moment. My version of the 350Z is getting pretty close to the final. One of the things I love on these import models are the wheel and tire packages that they have you put together. You can see those awesome calipers behind those gunmetal wheels and those slotted rotors. It is a very cool looking package. We'll pull those brake rotors out so you can see them up closer. Look at that. That's all box stock. You know, I build these things right out of here and just use simple materials to detail them. I've got the interior mostly put together. I've got the carbon fiber seat frames with the flat black foam padding inside. We got that center console in there. We got the cool chrome accent panel here. We got the subwoofers down here. So that interior looks very nice. On there, I did leave that completely chrome. I figured through that back deck lid, they'd want that completely chrome. Got our accented door panels like I showed you. Everything is looking tight and right. I like the contrast of the black to the gray. Check out the dashboard. A little bit of hand detailing with more of those gel pens. Since the pedals already had holes molded in them, I did them in the nice aluminum. I would also maybe do a clear blue on there. Would match the car body. Would look pretty cool. I did not use the gauge decals on the sheet. They are, even when you get close, they're pretty much just black circles. So I didn't bother. I just black washed inside all the gauges. In the center column where they have some gauges, I just black washed around it. Then I took a white pencil and lightly rubbed it on there. And now you can see those gauges fine. Did up the displays and everything on that dashboard and then lightly black washed the vents and everything. I like those import dashes and the silver gel pens of mine. Check it out. I even enhanced the Z on the steering wheel. Got that looking cool with the little buttons on the steering wheel. That's going to be a nice dashboard for that interior. You can see the body sitting back here. I haven't moved it because I just have the spoiler and the hood lightly set on there. But you can see I've got the door handles attached. The mirrors have to be attached. Very last thing. We've got those painted up and I've got the mirror glass in it. I have to do the windshield wipers and the back windshield wiper once the body's all assembled, and we've got that hood. See, I just love that oil rubbed bronze. To me, looks like carbon fiber with that very light fleck in it. That's a little shinier because being a metallic paint, they are pretty flat out of the bottle or out of the can for a Rust-Oleum. So I do hit those with some clear, just a Rust-Oleum clear, and then let that dry. And then I will also, once those are glued into place, I will be future floor polishing the entire body. The body has no clear on it at all, but the wing does. You can see how nice that looks. The hood does. The body has none at all, and I've got the tail lights and the reverse lights in it, so that needs a couple coats of future. We got the glass glued in, we got the headlight bezels glued in. Everything has gone together super easy without a fight at all. I've got that V6 under the hood now. I've got some paint drying on the fenders because I scuffed it up, so I just touched it up with black craft paint, which will dry flat soon. You can see that K&N element that I painted red and then washed on there for the air cleaner. We can see the Stower Tower strut bar underneath. See, when you black wash that exhaust, how nice it turns out with that toning on the stainless. Got everything running all the way back to that exhaust, and we're just going to leave it just as it is. It looks nice to me just the way it is, with that little bit of a different color skid plate bolted on the front, protection plate on there. I've got to push the wheel and tire package in place, glue the dashboard in, put them together. The interior fits with these two large pins. Just line it up in the pan right there, and that will push down and line everything up, and you can't see it from the bottom, so you don't have to worry about painting at all on the bottom. Then we'll get the body on, we'll get the wipers and the mirrors on. We're gonna just, I'm not really feeling any of these. The Toyota Supra, I loved that ghost striping they had. These ones, I'm not really feeling any of these different stripes on here on my nice blue metallic car because that plastic is so nicely colored. So, the carbon fiber decals are nice if you wanted to put them on the wing, but I painted mine up, so I'm just going to leave it as it is. We got to put the Z emblems on, we got to put the head emblem on, and then I will be deciding what I want to put on the car, if anything else. When we come back, we'll have that final. Another easy buildup, all said and done. I hope the camera's catching how deep the blue is. I'm going to see if the pictures at the end, I can actually work with them. This is a very dark blue. The box shows it as kind of a lighter blue. It's a nice tone with that metallic in there. Two coats of future floor polish over the top. I always like my little carbon fiber accents on the wing, the mirror, the door handles, and the hood. Exactly something who customizes a car would order offline and put it on their car so it looks extra tough. The dash, I'm gonna have separate pictures of the dash out of the body in the end of the video, because looking in through the windows, you can see it, but I won't be able to get a clear picture of it as easily. You can see down through the top of the car and check out that large chrome plate across the back. You really can't see the subwoofers in the back at all through the glass. You can get a little peek when you look through, it's just enough. So don't worry about detailing that back area too much. Underneath the car, like we showed before, that awesome exhaust system that I put on there to get it to look cool. And that wheel and tire package is something else. It's absolutely gorgeous. Those donut style tires just slide right on there. The low pros. You can see everything through the windshield though. You can see the mirror, the top of the dash, and all the other material. And then under the hood, that beautiful carbon fiber, we've got that nice Nissan V6 shoehorned underneath that little hood. That's why I wanted to paint the radiator a different color and the crossbar and stuff like that, so that the little bit of detail you can see under the hood of a car like this is noticeable. The taillights and the headlights just push in, and I held them in with Mod Podge as usual, and those dry clear. Check out, you can see that intercooler through the grill there. So a real easy build. It's a much more modern kit, so everything goes together like I showed you, the pins for the mirrors. I wish they did it on every single kit. I use the Nissan logo to cover up the VeilSide logo on the front bumper. I use that logo on there. I want it on mine, and I attached a 350Z logo next to the tail light and put the California, the regular California plate on it. And that's how I wanted mine to look. I didn't want the VeilSide logos on it. But the Nissan logo on the decal sheet looks great in the center of the front of the bumper. The hood goes on and off easily, drops right in. The wiper blades attached easily. Everything fits perfectly out of the box. I didn't need to sand or scrape. I floor polished right over the plastics. You can still see the seams where the body kit is put on the body. And they're not out of alignment. They don't look terrible. They're not all wonky. So that just shows how nicely that kit falls together for you. A first glue kit for someone who likes tuner style cars, this would easily be done by them in a weekend, which is what it took me, a couple days worth of work. As always, we thank Round 2 for sending over this copy. This kit is either out right now or on the way. Either way, I'll link down in the description where you can get yours on order so that you can have it right away. Thanks for watching the workshop. Build your models for you, and always have a good time with your hobby.